to show you home. Hey, hey. Put you on the gram, my baby. Wanna be a man, my baby. Be your best friend, my baby. I wanna show you home. Ooh, you fine, baby. And you mind, baby. I gotta show them the pride. I wanna show you home. Take pictures wherever we go. I was the whole world to know. Mother be fine, she shine, she go. I wanna show you off. Need a brother, let me with you to show you off. Let me take a couple pictures with you. Let me put you on my story. Make them jealous, make these hoes mad. Make them see what it looks like to go on dates with a real man. 10 by 10 by 10 by 10. Shorty so hot, need a fireman. I need her on the red carpet. So short, turn text when a girl walks in. Usually I keep it on the low, but I gotta put her on the pedestal. I wanna show you off. Put you in a grandma, baby. Wanna be a man, my baby. Be your best friend, my baby. I wanna show you all. Take pictures wherever we go. I was the whole world to know. Mama be fine, she shine, she go.
Hey.
I wanna show you all.
Sorry about that. That's my just favorite song ever right now. Literally, it just gets me so hype. Hey, I wanna show you all. I want the whole world to know. My baby fine and she shine and she go. Cause all that extra took her back to the crib for one night. Choke her up against the wall and we bout to all that extra stuff that men be talking about. That's just too much. I don't know why we have gotten to the point where we think that being choked up and being slammed down to the ground and—
or even the, this my B, this my what? Okay, you don't have any respect for me, I'm out of here.
Being disrespected and being sexualized, I don't know how in the world we got to where we are today in this world. But all I know is it tells me the Lord coming back. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Chloe Yasmeen, and in today's video, I am gonna be sharing with you guys my hygiene routine. I'm sorry, y'all, if my face is super red right now, we all know I have acne, but if my overall face is red, baby, it's hot as a mug up in here. I got this dang Hawks. Oh, also, I don't know what the Hawks are. Don't hold me to it. If you are against the Hawks, don't dislike this video just because you don't like the Hawks. I'm just playing. I don't care if you dislike it. You have the right to. I don't know what the Hawks are. I don't know if they're a baseball team, a football team, a soccer team. I don't know what the heck they are, so don't hold me to it. Disclaimer, I do not wash my hair every single day, obviously, and I also do not shave my legs and shave my armpits and everything every single day either. That's like an every 4 day, 3 day thing. It depends. I feel like with shaving, I probably shave every 2 to 3 days. And with washing my hair, I probably wash my hair every 4 to 5 days. And over time, not even like intentionally, like I didn't intentionally simplify my hygiene routine, but over time it just kind of got that way. When I first moved into my apartment, I didn't really have any bar soaps. I didn't really have any extra stuff. So I was just using the bare necessities. And honestly, ever since then, I kind of just kept up on the bare necessities and I don't really do all that. So with that being said, I'm not gonna ramble any longer. Did I already say that? Cause I feel like I did, but maybe I didn't. Let's go ahead and just hop right into the video. So obviously the very first thing that I do, if it is hair wash day, I'm gonna start off by getting my hair wet and I will jump right into shampooing my hair. Since I do not shampoo my hair as much as I used to, when I do shampoo my hair, I will shampoo it 3 times. And I'll make sure that I get it real good, like scrub my scalp really good. Honestly, one of my favorite shampoos right now is this The Mane Choice Pow. The Mane Choice has this new Pow line and it just smells super fruity. Yes, it smells really fruity. That's really all I can explain. But it kind of smells like Kool-Aid and fruit punch and fruit. But it smells really good and it's super strong. So I'll just go ahead and shampoo my scalp 3 times. I don't focus too much on the length of my hair because I don't want to like dry out my hair. But I still do wash the length of my hair. But I mostly focus on my scalp, especially on that third wash. And I just find that washing my hair and scrubbing my scalp 3 times while I'm in there, it just keeps my scalp fresh longer. You never want to use your nails to scrub your scalp. You always want to use the palms of your fingers, especially if you are prone to like dandruff and stuff like that. Honestly, even if you're not prone to dandruff, if you're scrubbing your scalp with your nails, it will cause dandruff. You're scratching your scalp, you're damaging your scalp. Just make sure that you are cleansing the whole entire scalp and not just certain parts of your scalp. Make sure you're getting every little part of your scalp. Once I get done washing my hair, I will go in with whatever conditioner that I'm using at the moment, which is most likely the matching conditioner to the shampoo. I will go ahead and leave this all over my hair, even on my scalp. I know a lot of people disagree with using conditioner on your scalp, but I personally like to use conditioner on my scalp. I think it makes my hair smell better and it just makes my hair more moisturized and stuff like that. I tend to have super dry scalp anyway, so I'll just go ahead and leave the conditioner in just for the overall scent, because leaving the conditioner in makes your hair smell so much better, like especially if the conditioner is nicely scented. And it also just helps me to detangle my hair. It also makes my hair super soft. Now that we are done discussing and going over my hygiene routine for my scalp and my hair and everything, just like the shampoo and conditioning, girl, let's hop right into my body. So like I mentioned earlier, I haven't really been using bar soap, and I really should be. But I've just been getting really lazy, and body wash has been working for me. And it's just like my go-to, like whatever body wash I'm using. I don't have like a specific body wash that I stay loyal to. I'm actually using a Walmart Equate Castile soap right now, like a knockoff Castile soap, and it's been working really well, the peppermint one. But I just go through body wash super fast. Like, I use so much body wash. Like, everybody talking about some, you're never gonna be able to get through all those. That's a dang lie, because I have been living in my apartment for like a month now, and I've already gone through like 15 body washes, because I have so many different body washes, and some body washes just do not get soapy like that, so I have to use Heka body wash. But with Dove body washes, these are honestly the best body washes ever. Dove would definitely be the way to go if you are looking for a good body wash. They last long, they really do have a very beautiful rich lather, and they make you smell really good. This one right here is the cucumber and green tea. This would have to be one of the strongest smelling ones that they have, and you really will walk out of the shower smelling like cucumber and green tea. Now, I don't want to tell anybody don't be using bar soap if you're using bar soap, but I'm just letting you guys know my hygiene routine at the moment, and it's been working perfectly for me. I believe bar soap is like the bomb.com to really for real get clean. But lately, like I said, I've just been being super lazy, and I just reach for body wash. Now, my body cleansing routine is a little bit different. So I actually like to focus on my underarms before I go into any other part of my body. So I'll get whatever washcloth I'm using. My favorite washcloths are from Target. So I'll get whatever washcloth that I'm using. I'll get a good amount of body wash on there. I will wet my underarms because I do not like how like silicone-y and like the texture of deodorant underneath my armpits, and I literally cannot apply any more deodorant on my underarms if I get out of the shower and I still feel like my underarms are squeaky. That means I didn't fully clean my underarms yet. So I'll go ahead and get a lot of body wash, and then I'll just focus on my underarms. Focus. This is gonna be a little different. This is the part where it's a little bit weird, but I think it's like my like weird things, or like things that I just have going on. This side has a tag on it. This is the side that I wash my underarms with. I just feel like the chemicals and like the silicones and all the different stuff that deodorant has, I don't want that on my body. So I use the side with the tag for my underarms to go ahead and focus on those first. And then I'll go onto the other side and clean my body. Another reason why you want to focus on them is because, you know, certain parts of our body produce more odors than others. And so those parts, those are like your focus points, and you really want to focus on those points. Armpits being one of them. Them armpits can get loud. Okay, so just make sure that you're cleaning them real good. After I get done washing my underarms, I'll just go in with the body wash again and get a lot. I really do not like scrimping on my body wash because I feel like the overall experience of a shower should be nice. And I feel like you don't really have a good and nice experience in a shower unless the soap is just dripping off the rag and it's just so soapy. You just feel so clean. You get out, you can smell the soap in the air, you know? So I just go ahead and I get a good amount. I clean the heck out of my neck. Get the back of my neck, get the back of my ears, get my whole entire body. Focus on yourself. Get the side of your back, just focus. Get your whole entire body, soap your whole body up. I feel like it is self-explanatory, so I'm not gonna go into detail on how to like clean your skin, because it's just soap to skin and put some elbow grease and if you don't know what elbow grease is, just put some strength, put some pressure, and just go ahead and clean your body. I do that twice. Not just one time, baby, that first time ain't gonna do it. That second time, yes ma'am. And you're gonna notice that second time that you clean your body's gonna get more soapy, because the first round of you cleaning your body, it was trying to get rid of that first layer of dirt. The dirt and the grime and the dust and the stuff and the oils and the lotions and the perfumes, it's trying to get rid of that first, so it's not gonna get too soapy. That second round, that's gone. So now we're doing an extra cleanse to make sure everything is done. Just like the first time when you wash your hair, it's not gonna get that soapy. That second time is gonna get super soapy. That third time is gonna get extra soapy. I don't just get in and out. I like to clean my body for about 2 minutes each time and really cleanse my body and get my whole entire body clean. Sorry y'all, I got text messages coming through today. My feet, my back, my underarms, behind my ears, and my belly button. Those are my focus points. I just like to make sure that those are extra, extra clean, because everywhere else doesn't really produce body odors except for what I'm about to get into. Now, let me also mention that 2 minutes of washing your body, even though I try to do that as much as possible, 2 minutes isn't always realistic. So cut that down to 1 minute if you are running on a very fast and tight schedule. Now, as far as my behind, you may be wondering, I thought we already went over this. That's a part of scrubbing your body. Personally, I do not wash my behind while I'm washing my body. I just don't really, I don't like that. I feel like your behind should have its own hygiene routine, just like your downstairs area has its own hygiene routine, your scalp has its own hygiene routine. You know, you're not getting a washcloth and washing your face with the same soap you're washing your body and washing your head and washing your downstairs area and washing your... That's not really it. You want to have different soaps and different routines for different areas, because not every area works the same and not every area is going to react the same. So with that being said, I have a whole hygiene routine on how I keep my behind fresh all day. I struggled for so long, you know, being young. I think that's a part of just being a kid. You know, you don't really know how to properly clean yourself. But when I got to a certain age and I really started to understand hygiene and I really started to understand body odor, I started to get really frustrated because I just could not get rid of bad odors back there and then downstairs and then on my scalp. Like, I really struggled with certain parts of my body. And the certain parts of my body that I struggled with growing up would be my scalp. And it was because I wasn't really focusing and getting all in there three times and letting the conditioner sit for a little while. My underarms, and that's because I wasn't thoroughly cleaning them and getting all of the deodorant off. And then my behind, and then my downstairs area. I struggled with that so long. So I have a whole entire video on my behind hygiene routine, how to have 24-hour freshness. Honestly, that hygiene routine has changed my life because I'm always super confident that I smell good and I'm always fresh back there. It doesn't matter how much I sweat, it doesn't matter what I do, I am always confident because I keep my behind super fresh with the routine that I've shared with you guys in the video down below. Now let's hop into shaving. Like I said earlier, I don't shave every single day, but when I do, this is my routine. I'm not gonna get into my intimate shaving routine because I have a video on that as well. I have an intimate shaving routine from front to back. I've gotten so many emails from my behind 24-hour freshness video and my intimate shaving routine because I cannot stand razor bumps and ingrowns and, oh my gosh, like hyperpigmentation. I hate all of it, and I'm sharing with you guys my routine on those videos. I've gotten so much good feedback that you guys have tried my routines and you guys are just like, oh my gosh, this is crazy. Where have I been? What rock have I been under? So I have my behind routine and I also have my intimate shaving routine from front to back linked down below. Those two videos are amazing. I'm 100% confident in. They are great. They will really help you. So I think everybody's pretty much aware that, like, I was a very big fan of Tree Hut scrubs. I was a very big fan of scrubs, period, exfoliation, all of that, which I still do exfoliation, but I do more like chemical exfoliation and stuff like that. But as far as my body, yeah, I haven't really been doing any body scrubs. I haven't really been doing all the extra stuff. I honestly found out that, like, Tree Hut scrubs were breaking me out. And I honestly feel like I started to back up off of all of, like, the hygiene crazy amount of products when everybody started to do it on TikTok and it started to blow up and it was, like, shower talk and hygiene talk. I started to back away from it because I really didn't want to do what everybody else was doing. So I haven't been using any body scrubs, and honestly, my skin's been doing amazing. Like, I don't, you know. But this Soap and Glory scrub, if you are gonna get a scrub, I do suggest this one. This one is called the Scrub of Your Life. This right here is amazing. I had heard so many good things about it. I just was not really sure if it was true. It did not want to focus, but here it is. I actually get mine from Target. It smells so nice. It gets, like, a nice lather. It's a beautiful exfoliator. I love this stuff so much. It really does make my skin super soft. Amazing. I love this. My legs are literally always super shiny from using this scrub. Makes my skin feel super smooth, and it just adds, like, this extra fun into the shower. So I just go ahead and I use this all over my whole entire body. I scrub my underarms, scrub my back, scrub everywhere, because this scrub does not break me out. It actually has been helping, actually, with the bumps in the back of my arms. After I get done exfoliating, I always exfoliate before I shave, because I used to always exfoliate after I shave. That was not very smart. First of all, you want to get rid of the dead skin, and you also want to give yourself a smooth surface to go ahead and shave. If you exfoliate before shaving, it's going to give you a closer shave so that your shave can last longer. My favorite razor, this razor is crazy. It has totally changed my shaving game. I love it so much. When I tell you guys, my hair on my legs does not grow back that fast with this razor. This is the Gillette Venus Deluxe Smooth Sensitive Razor. I love this so much, and they even came out with the matching shave cream. So I've been using the matching shave cream, but I'm gonna be real with you guys. Would I repurchase this again? Probably not, just because I'm not picky with shave cream. I'll literally shave with bar soap, and I'll shave with body wash. Like, I don't really care, you know. But I have been using this, and it does smell very nice. It's like a honey flower shave cream. It smells really, really, really nice. I'm not the biggest floral fan, like floral scents, but it does smell really nice, and it does give me a smooth shave. So I just go ahead and I get the cream, get a good amount all over my hand, and then I rub it back and forth, get it all over my leg, and then I lightly and slowly shave my legs and my underarms. If I don't lightly or slowly shave My legs will become very sensitive, and then my underarms will become very sensitive as well. I cannot be shaving hard. I've learned my lesson from that, and I also have super sensitive underarms, so I make sure to use HECA shave cream just so that it's not razor to skin. It's like razor to shave cream, but also to skin, because my underarms are super sensitive. If you're noticing that your legs or anywhere is like getting kind of raw and kind of like not feeling too well, like it's been scraped or anything of the sort, go ahead and change your razor head. You have to have a fresh, sharp razor on your razor head, or you will get cut, you will get razor burn, you will get all of it. And if you're seeing any rust, my dad used to make this such a big deal. My dad had a drug addiction, and so he would not buy me like what I needed, like for hygiene wise. He did it a couple times and I was like super excited trying to like save the products. But this one time I ran out of my shavers and stuff like that, my razors and stuff, and I told my mom, I said, yeah, my razors are starting to get rust on them. She was like, what did you just say? I said, yeah, they're starting to get like rust on them. She was like, don't you ever use that razor again. She told me, like, I don't have the money to buy you any razors right now. Please tell your dad about it, because your dad made it clear to me. When my mom and dad first got together or whatever, he had told her, like, do not use any razor that has rust on it. You can die if that gets into your bloodstream. So I was like, yeah, like, I need new razors, but I still wasn't, like, telling him, like, they had rust on it. And he's like, no, I can't really afford that right now, this and this and that. I'm like, yeah, well, they have rust on them. He was like, excuse me? Okay, let's go. And he took me up to Dollar General and got me new razors. So please never, ever use a razor that has rust on it. That's why you always want to have your razor in a dry place. Either hang it, or let it be face up. Once it's face down, it's not breathing. It's gonna get rusty. The last thing that I do is I clean my downstairs area. The reason why I do that last is because, and why everybody should do it last, is because if you clean your downstairs area the first thing you do, or the second to last thing you do, let's say you wash your downstairs area and then you go ahead and rinse out the conditioner or rinse off your body, that's gonna travel downstairs. And then when you get out of the shower, you're gonna wonder, why am I irritated? Why is my pH being knocked off? Why? Because there's still soap down there, there's still product down there, there's still shave cream, whatever it is. That's why cleaning your downstairs area should be the very last thing. So anything that might have traveled down there, you can clean off. Baby washcloth, Baby Dove. I love this one. This is the rich moisture one. It has a very mild scent to it. Lightly scented, it's for babies, it's very good. And then they also have the unscented one, which I really also like. Now, if you're saying unscented soap don't work for me, how long did you give it enough time to work for you? Did you at least give it a month? Your body has built up a tolerance for Summer's Eve or whatever you're using. It's had to build up a tolerance for that, and your tolerance is pretty high. So obviously, if you're gonna go ahead and use something unscented or mildly scented that doesn't have things to block odors, you're gonna have some type of odor, but your body has to adjust. And this is what it needs to be adjusting to. It's unscented lotion or I mean, not lotion, unscented soap or mild scented soap. I clean my downstairs area twice. I actually get 5 to 6 pumps on a washcloth. You get it on there and then you just go ahead and clean. Clean, 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 clean. Get all in between. Just do not get the hole, which is the actual vagina. Okay, but get all the crevices, get everything except for the hole. Then you want to go ahead and rinse off and then do it again. Clean, 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 clean. 5 to 6 pumps, that's what I do. And I use the rougher side. And on a baby washcloth, obviously it's not rough, but it's the rougher side. Now, as far as the hole and the actual vagina part, if you're wondering what do? You can either leave it alone because it is self-cleaning, or what I do is I just take my hand and I just go ahead and clean it with water very lightly. There's no need to go up, no, just lightly cleanse it with water. I personally do that because I still feel like it needs to be cleansed a little bit, but just with water. Everywhere else can be cleansed, just not the hole. Because I used to be so confused coming up on YouTube. When hygiene routines first started, I used to be so confused when girls used to be like, just clean your vagina with water. I used to be like, what are you saying right now? But then you're also telling me to use soap. So what are you talking about? Whole time they meant to say the hole, clean that with water. Everything else you can use unscented soap. Super simple with my downstairs area, right? Super simple. Now I'm out of the shower, I hop right into my post feminine shaving routine. All of that is in that video down below, what I do after I get done shaving my downstairs area. I do that whole entire routine to prevent razor bumps, to prevent ingrowns, and to prevent all types of stuff that could be going on. Once I get done with my feminine hygiene, I will go straight in with whatever perfume. Now you may be wondering, why not go in with lotion? I like to layer my products, so I go in with whatever perfume I'm wearing. I don't just wear one perfume though. I actually do not like for people to smell like me, so I always mix perfumes. And I'll tell people if they ask me, like, what do you have on? I'll tell them, like, I have have three different perfumes on. I have two different perfumes on. I usually wear 2 to 3 different perfumes, max 4, but I always know what can be mixed together, you know? Yesterday I wore these two. This is my Gabrielle Chanel Essence, and this is my Alien by Terry Mugler Goddess. I mixed these two together. This is like a creamy vanilla, and this is just like, it just smells like a rich boss, a business trip type of chick, okay? I mixed these two. This lady yesterday was like, she was nervous. She was like, your fragrance, it smells so good. I don't know what it is. She said, but you smell so good. I'm like, thank you. You can use a body spray or you can use your perfume. If you're gonna use body spray, use extra. So I just go ahead and spray my whole entire body down. Spray. Get my next perfume, spray. Get whatever lotion I'm using. I don't use no Bath & Body Works or no Victoria's Secret. I don't do all that because they break me out so bad and they're just not good for the skin. They have like parabens and like all types of stuff. And if you like to tan like me, whether you're outside tanning or whether you're indoor tanning, whatever it is, Bath & Body Works and Victoria's Secret, they take away from your tan. So your tan will not last if you're using products like that. You probably don't care about that if you're not a tanner, but I'm just letting you guys know if you do like to tan, it does take away from your tan. And if you have body acne, please do not use Bath & Body Works and Victoria's Secret. It will really break you out. It does make you smell good, but it really does break you out. I use whatever little cheap lotion I got. I love the Jergens coconut, the hydrating coconut one. That's my favorite. Lately, I've just been trying to go through my little lotions. So lately, I've been using this Nivea oil infused lotion, vanilla, in the scent vanilla and almond oil. This isn't anything that I'm gonna suggest because I'm honestly not the biggest fan of it. I'm not the biggest fan of the scent. It's super light, but I still always smell good. I only use this for moisture, but I still always smell good either way because I still spray my body down. I still spray my clothes down. My hair always still smells good and stuff like that. So with that being said, I just moisturize with whatever lotion. I literally have a whole routine. Like I use 3 pumps for my leg, 1 pump for my behind, and 3 more pumps for my upper body. So I kind of go from the bottom on up. After I get done moisturizing, I go in with whatever perfume again and I spray my whole entire body down again. I get this spraying. Oh my gosh, this smells so good. Oh my gosh, this smells so good, baby. This, ooh, I love to smell good. I love to smell good. And like I said, if you cannot afford expensive perfumes, get you some Bath & Body Works body spray or Victoria's Secret body spray and spray a whole lot of it because I used to get heck of compliments back in the day even when wearing the cheaper body sprays because I used to spray a lot of it. Then I go ahead and get dressed and I go ahead and I apply my deodorant. Never apply your deodorant before you get dressed because you won't get deodorant stains on your stuff. But I use 17 swipes of deodorant each armpit. My favorite deodorant that has been working so good lately is the pH Balance Secret Powder Fresh Deodorant. This deodorant is really good. I'm sorry, it's not focusing. This deodorant is so good, you guys. I'm literally obsessed. It works amazing. And I use 17 swipes on each armpit. Yes, I'm very specific because I do it every single day. Perfume again. And that is how I get my perfume to last, baby, because I do 3 layers of perfume. Okay. Spray your clothes. Okay. Your skin, that scent on your skin, it's not going to last too long. And if it does last, it's going to fade to something real faint where people cannot smell it. Spray your clothes because those fibers in your clothes, they're gonna hold on to that scent. You know, even if I get done washing my clothes, I can still smell my perfume sometimes. So spray your clothes. Your clothes are what's gonna make your perfume last. And I literally get compliments on how I smell. Like every single time that I go in public, I'm always getting compliments. I went to go get my lashes done the other day and this lady was like, please tell your friend. She told my lash tech, please tell your friend that I used her trick on mixing perfumes. And she said, my husband was like, you smell so good. Like, oh my gosh, you smell so good. She was like, so now I know how to smell good, okay? Cause she was like, you lit up the whole entire room. When she came in to get her lashes done, cause she works at the lash salon, when she came in to get her lashes done, she smelled me, like just coming into the room, And so after I got done getting my lashes done, she was like, I was just wondering what the smell was. It was you the whole time. And she was smelling me. She was like, what do you have on? And I told her I mixed my Coco Noir with my Libre by YSL. And she went and bought both of those perfumes and she mixes them and she smells so good. So that was super cool. But anyway, I'm not gonna hold you guys any longer. God bless you all in Jesus' name. I hope you guys get, I hope we can all smell good together. Anyway, with that being said, your girl's gonna go ahead and hit up out of here.